Start recording, start streaming, push the button, Max. Start the everything, turn on all the stuff. And here we are. Yes, there we go. There's a bit of a gap between when I hit the button and when it starts to actually record things. And that's partially because... Partially that's because I'm using OBS as my program thingy, and that's why that's happening there. And now, for some inadequately explained reason, it decided it didn't want to show video, so I'm not gonna start the video part until I get the camera turned on. Turn on, camera. There we go. Oh, silly me. I had the slidey thing closed, so that shows you exactly where my brain is. And that's why the theme of today's show is songs that Maffoo can play easily. There we are, hi. I learned a very small amount of the C blues scale and fiddle around with it some. Yep. All right. So let's talk a little bit about yesterday. Yesterday was a fun show, but it was kind of awkward in places. And a lot of the awkwardness can easily be attributed to the fact that the opening riff for Paperback Writer continues to stymie me when I am doing it in front of people I assume are watching. It's the Heisenberg uncertainty theory. So today's show is stuff you've probably heard me do before if you've been hanging out with me on these things. Although, there is an additional track in there because I feel like being kind of goofy about it, so what the heck. Let's put on the percussion instrument. That's right. Several very small BBs in a cylinder attached to a piece of elastic attached to my hand. Show the hand over here instead of over here where nobody can see it. Hand. Let's see what happens. A black and white cow print cat known as Domino. Domino is a little over a year old when we adopted Domino, we thought she was older. She was effectively a toddler with a 7-foot vertical leap. And all that this entails. The older cat that I have shown off around here a little bit, big fluffy thing called Delilah, is now, I think, maybe closing in on 7 if she hasn't hit it yet. Domino is still learning how to cat, and Delilah has just about had it because she's learning how to cat all over Delilah. All right. So, again, songs that are fairly easy for me to play. I'm figuring out where I'm supposed to sit here. I have to keep remembering that what I'm seeing on the screen is basically a reverse of what I'm actually doing here. So... my beloved has come in looking for things. But that's not the point. Let's do the song. Let me get the song up to where I can see it. Just in case, I have another terrible brain fart, which has happened on multiple occasions. And frankly, I'd like to get through this entire thing relatively intact. 2, 3, and... woke up this morning, crawled out of bed, went down to the dining hall, and here's what they said. They said the world's going crazy. I asked what they did. They said the boy's coming to Hogwarts. The boy that lived, well, it's hard. It's so hard to be a Hufflepuff. We're just trying to get along now, just trying to play it cool. Gonna do my 7 years and get the heck out of school. But then we're dealing with dementors, deaf eaters in the halls, and I heard that there's a trolley in the girls' bathroom stalls. Well, it's hard, it's so hard to be a Hufflepuff. Been grabbing along for years now, I'm sure you can relate. I want to survive the forbidden forest and just graduate. Well, they want us to participate, but we ain't that thrilled. I mean, we gave them Cedric Diggory, they went and got him killed. Well, it's hard, too soon. It's so hard, it's always too soon to be a Hufflepuff. I mean, look, you get down to it, there's like 4 houses, right? You got the brave ones, the smart ones, the clever ones, and us. And the rest. What nobody realizes is that we gotta clean up after all the maniacs out there go out and do all that stuff. You know who's left? Fruit Group, baby. Well, the battle lasted all through the day and all through the night, and we're just trying to get our batch of skins out of this stupid fight. Well, they're watching the kid with glasses, hoping he'd save the day, and then this little schlub on bottom grabbed a sword and blew us all away. Well, it's hard. It's hard to believe he's not a Hufflepuff. Fruit, fruit, baby. I am Hufflepuff according to the almost all the tests, and that's okay. My wife is a Ravenclaw, by her own admission, which is all right as well. I have absolutely nothing against Gryffindors, except that they have a real serious collateral damage issue. But that's a whole nother conversation for a whole nother time. What else I got going on here today? Well, it's the 22nd, and this is show 21, which I think means that technically this show is now old enough to drink, in performance terms. Probably not, but it's still kind of cute to say. I was thinking about making like an alcohol-themed show, but nah, I wanted to be a little bit more laid back and relaxed here. So, I did add in an additional thing, which we'll get to, after this. I'm doing a lot of blues here. I apparently wrote a lot of blues, which is interesting. Because, you know, I'm a white dude from Salt Lake City, Utah. Which is as Caucasian as is allowed by law. It's a true story. Well, that's what these strings are for. Maraca. Actually, is it? Yeah, it's one maraca, two maracas, three. What's going on here? Four. Okay, now you're just being silly. I'm gonna take off the maraca for the next one. I was gonna do just four songs. I thought, you know, I'm trying to do songs that are easy for me to play. that has a tendency to be shorter songs. And I decided I wanted to do one that I did, and it was well-received, with occasional screams of outrage and anger. So I figured I'd do it again, the screams of outrage and anger. And it is based upon a traditional sea shanty, but this is, of course, a traditional Serenity class sea shanty. this is not entirely my fault. This is co-written by myself, Loreen, who's one of my Patreon patrons, and Kit, who comes and hangs out here on occasion and may actually be lurking somewhere in the distance. I can't tell from here. It's very difficult to say because I can't see if he's there or not. Move the cursor. Yes, I have a cursor. I don't have perfect technology. I only have semi-perfect technology there. Okay, let's see here. It's also in the key of C. An awful lot of what I do is in the key of C, because the key of C is a good key for a tenor ukulele. Also, you know, I used to be very worried because I do a lot of stuff with C, G, F, and a few other, you know, D, E, but a lot of it's C, G, and F. Then I remembered something that Kinky Friedman said once about Tom T. Hall. He said, I love all of Tom T. Hall's songs and both of his melodies. And then I felt better. My ship got stopped by an EMP. Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Now they're gonna eat but not kill me. And I'm dinner for a Reaver. Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Oh, Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Chu Shang Ta Zhao Da Zhang Ho. Gonna run away from the Reavers. Oh, I thought in space I would be free. Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Those blue-handled goons, they won't get me. Gonna run away from the Reavers. Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Oh, Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Ah, Chu Shang Cha Zhao Da Zhang Ho. Gonna run away from the Reavers. Oh, I thought my cunning would prevail. Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Curse your sudden but inevitable betrayal. And he got ate by a Reaver. Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Oh, Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Ah, Chu Shang Cha Zhao Da Zhang Ho. Gonna run away from the Reavers. Oh, he floated like a leaf on the wind. Reaver, Johnny Reaver. As a hood ornament, he found his end. Still too soon. 'Cause he got killed by a Reaver. Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Oh, Reaver, Johnny Reaver. Ah, Chu Shang Cha Zhao Da Zhang Ho. Gonna run away from the Reavers. That always leaves a lump in my throat, and if I sing it for the wrong crowd, several lumps on my head. Nerd moment. I have not seen very many episodes of Firefly. I know that may shock some of you. But thanks to the internet, I know a lot about Firefly because we have the internet. And the blue-handled goon-handed goons line in there is that they're not Reavers. Clearly, they're not Reavers. They're 2x2 hands of blue. And I will probably look at trying to change that verse to make it reflect the fact the Reavers tend to be ugly, hideously deformed, with metal shoved through their bodies in weird places, and so forth. Probably. Eventually. And yes, Kay, Austin really ought to hear this song, preferably from a distance. So, you know, I'm sure once this is done and it's up there on the interwebs on Facebook, you can point him toward it, and I'll just listen for the screams of outrage from North Texas. It is a lot of fun to do, though. I'm very happy with it. I do have the recorded version of it with me doing four-part harmony on my SoundCloud, which I will doubtless talk about in a little bit when we get to the end credits here. All right. One more song. Trying to make this a fairly relaxed show because I really faced a lot of frustration with that riff from Paperback Writer, and it still continues to stymie me. There is an actual riff, an opening riff. Well, it's a Stevie Ray Vaughan song, Life by the Drop, and there is a whole riff that goes along with it, and there's actually a couple different ways to play it, and there's very much a blues pick and kind of... But I'm not... I'm not a blues picky kind of guy. Yet. I'm basically a strum and pray kind of guy. And so I'm not going to damage myself with that riff on a video until I know I can do it right. And it probably means I won't do the riff for Renaissance Minstrel the next couple times I play it, just so I know I can actually get the bloody thing down eventually. But enough introspection. Let's do the line of the song. Started over again, living the dream of you on top. My mind is aching and Lord, it won't stop. That's how it happens, living life by the drum. Up and down the road in our worn out shoes, talking about good things and singing the blues. Just a matter of time. Living the dream of you on top. My mind is aching and Lord, it won't stop. That's how it happens, living life by the drop. No waste of time, we're allowed today. Churning up the past and there's no easier way. Good to be here walking together. Together, my friend. Almost made it. Living the dream. My mind stopped aching. And that's how it happens, living life by the drum. That's how it happens, living life by the drum. Even with a little hiccups and stuff, because I am not very good at this, with the official motto and disclaimer of the Troubadork show, that went okay. I do love that song. I like a lot of Stevie Ray Vaughan. Stevie Ray Vaughan played guitar like it was trying to get away from him. And if you've ever seen a video of it, he literally plays guitar like it's trying to get away from him. So, 21 shows, man. depending on who you talk to and who you believe, either we're going to open up for business wildly and casually and damn the torpedoes, or we're going to do it real slow and sensible. And a lot of it's going to have to do with where you are, in what state, in what part of the country, and who you plan to listen to. So either we'll have another, today is Wednesday, I'll do another show this week and we'll see what happens, or we'll just keep doing this until I get good at this or we all get sick of it. I mean, either option is open there. So let's talk about it here. The tip jars, of course, are there. Someone actually sent me money, which really surprised the heck out of me, and I appreciate that. Actually, two people sent me money, which is really startling. I guess if you have disposable income and you want to support adequacy in our lifetime, fantastic. If you don't have money, do not panic. This is an entirely free show. I am not doing this as my career. I have a day job. I'm doing this because I don't have to drive home from my day job, because I'm doing my day job here at home in an undisclosed location in San Antonio, Texas. Let's see. SoundCloud, I told you that I have the four-part harmony Reaver Johnny track there, and it is me doing all four parts, and which means I got to play four different personalities, which means we got a lot of reactions on that last line in there. I enjoyed doing that. I still don't like alto parts, but that's because altos tend to get boring parts a lot. All my old shows are at facebook.com/TobiasTheAdequate, which is also the Tobias the Adequate website on Facebook. Theadequate.com is currently kind of in stasis. I'm looking at what I may do to move that from where it currently is to another location using a whole other set of tools, and it'll probably look really different and weird later. You can, of course, find me on YouTube at youtube.com/mplaguerre, because The Adequate was already taken. The Troubadork shows and a whole bunch of other stuff is on there in a bunch of different playlists. I am still doing magic, just not as much of it, because I can perform music to a video and feel like I'm doing it right. If I do a participatory magic act to a video camera, there's a lot of dead air, or my show is really short, because there's no audience response. So there's that. Carpe Diem Comics is, of course, the official emotional support comic shop of Tobias the Adequate, the Adequate Podcast, The Troubadork Show over here, and, well, just nifty stuff in general. CarpeDiemComics.com is the website. CarpeDiemComicsOnline.square.site is the online store. Check them out. They've got a lot of stuff, and if you don't see it, ask. They may have it, and they just may not have it in inventory yet. Also, do take time to support your own local comic shops, game stores, and other places. If you can do mail order, great. If you can't, buy a couple of gift certificates. They're like a love letter to your future self. Patreon.com allows you to support Adequacy in our lifetime. We currently have 4 Patreon patrons. That's John and Brian and Lorene and Alicia, and I appreciate y'all so very much. I do try to get some preview stuff in there because we are in weird organizational structure issues. I don't do as many previews as I could, but eventually we'll have this thing set up so I can just sit down and just push a button and do the thing, as opposed to what I have to do now, which involves either getting this going again or getting my camera, putting it on this tripod, setting it up over here, doing the thing, fixing the video in Splice, which is what I use on the iOS. Highly recommended. They're tagged with GoPro, but you don't need a GoPro to use it, and it works really well, and it's free. And then posting it out to YouTube as an unlisted video, and then linking it to the Patreon site. That's welcome to the seamy world of creating videos for people who want to give you money. It's a weird place, but it's homey. I think that's really it for this show. I think it's been I've had a good time. I hope y'all have had a good time. Not as many comments as normal, but it's Wednesday. I mean, we're all kind of in that, what day is it, where am I, what exactly am I doing here, what color are my pants, am I wearing pants, should I be wearing pants? Whose pants are these, anyway? Situation. So, y'all have been wonderful once again. Thank you for listening. Tell your friends, tell your enemies, it will confuse them. Tell your neighbors, it will confuse them even more because they haven't heard of me. The Troubadork Show bravely staggers forward. Thank y'all so very much. We will now do the customary crossfade to the card, which allows me to make faces at the camera, which you can't see. And then we'll do a very gentle, gradual fade to black so that I can put up the YouTube pictures there and the little buttons that'll happen over on the side of the screen there. Because after all, YouTube is weird, but so am I. Thanks y'all again. This has been awesome. Y'all take care.